Hey Dota fans, a lot happened this week. Let's kick off with Heroic in South America. They made the decision to move David Parker Flores into the inactive roster and have brought in Yuma Lenglet as the stand-in for the upcoming Blast tournament in Denmark. Heroic wrote on X and said that there was an incident during the ESL1 Bangkok qualifiers where they had a disagreement with the strategy from Parker and his desire to win, and which it did not align with Heroic's professional standards. Heroic announced Yuma will be the stand-in while saying they are open to transfer Parker to another team if they choose to pick him up. Parker did respond on Facebook with his list of team disagreements. To summarize some of his points, Parker mentioned that he was asked to not pick Monkey King because it wasn't good in lane and they needed Hero to beat Bristleback. Another was Parker accusing his teammate KJ of belittling him during a game, and he also accused of Dalai Lama hurting him mentally during Dream League. Looking back at the ESL1 qualifiers, a lot of fans are pointing to Game 5, where Parker decided to teleport mid and push for Barracks instead of staying and fighting for Roshan, which Heroic lost right after losing Roshan. Here's the clip.
Cooldown comes in, a lot of damage on the backline with the magic. Illich is still staying alive. Divide with the ulti pike. Can he get himself back? Yes, he can. And actually, Parker needs to be careful. His mana is gone.
Magnetize.
Oh, the magnetize comes out.
Dead?
Parker's dead.
That magnetize is so much damage.
He does have a buyback available if they want to go back in. They break the Bristleback. He's trying to fall back. Parker's going to buy back to rejoin the fray. Analog about to get taken down. Can he stay alive? He's going to lose his life. And it will be buyback from the Radiant side as well. They are going to disengage here. And Pike needs to be very careful. He was lurking about a little bit too much. Has the TP at the ready, joking his way through everything. And is going to get the TP back to base. But that means they will be able to get that second Rosh.
Pyke cannot stand his ground in those fights. Like, he just cannot stand his ground to the Dusa. It's just... Parker's way too farmed.
Rosh is so close to dropping.
Oh my lord, Heroic. They are so scared here. They're holding on to the analog buyback. He will go for it. It's gonna be another 5v5. Pretty much every buyback being used.
This is a do or die fight. Right
still
now,
five buybacks available here. Most of them on Beast Coast.
They need to be careful they don't steal it. Where's Parker going?
I think he wants to use Boots of Travel level 2. He's gonna be showing mid, push the wave. And he doesn't want to be the first point of contact. But the problem is, Rosh is so low that Beast Coast, they're gonna yoink it.
Yeah, they don't hear the roar in response. Rosh is dead. Free Ags, Aegis. Lasso Ags
on
Analog.
Spirit.
Analog, he's in trouble. Analog is gonna die. No buyback available. And the chase is gonna be deeper from Lumpy. They find Schofield.
Parker is getting barracks.
Parker is pushing high ground, but it doesn't really matter if his entire team is dead. The Vi Lama, he does have a buyback available at the very least. He's trying to go back in onto El Micho, but he will be found. And yeah, Parker, he did, you know, 1,000 damage to the tier 3 tower. Congratulations, your team might have just lost the game.
That was so weird. Because like, once, if you want to give away...
In North America, the X-Nouns, now called the Atlantic City, has called it quits. Tall Fly Azit wrote on X to make the announcement. He wrote that it's a sad day to end their journeys together, but ultimately this was for the best. Fly continued and said that they had a glimmer of greatness throughout the year, but they were never able to capitalize and make it consistent, which is truly the goal of a top team. Fly ended by saying, "The recent results and the loss of a sponsor resulted in low morale and confidence within the group." He thanked his teammates for the good times. Over to tournament news. The one-win Dota series fall concluded this week, and Team Liquid might have finally came together. It's a small tournament, but Team Liquid did defeat Team Spirit in a sweep to claim their first one-win title. Here is their winning moment.
To Team Spirit.
Yeah, let them come out of the base. Let them come to our high ground where we're gonna crush them. Satanic is attacking from the low ground and doing absolutely nothing to this Muerta. And his four staff gets canceled out. Mepotka says, go and fight Satanic. Yo, kid, why are you running away? Well, he is running away because he cannot fight. He's gonna die to the boundless strike. The egg was used on the other side. Let's see if it can survive. Even though they didn't focus on it in the first couple of seconds, they're gonna kill it. No issue. And Team Spirit are gonna be going in. They are not afraid of dying, but that is exactly exactly what's gonna be happening to them because they've got no chance to win this fight, no chance to win this game and stay in this tournament. It will be Liquid that are our champions and will be taking home $50,000.
Here are the ESL One Bangkok qualified teams that will be playing in December from 9th to the 15th. The groups have not been announced yet, but Team Falcons, BetBoon Team, Team Spirit, and Paravision were all invited through Dreamly and the ESL One Pro Tour points. Team Liquid, Avulis, PogChamp, Nigma Galaxy, Gaozhu, Boom Esports, Shopify Rebellion, and Beast Coast all joined through the qualifiers. The Blast Slam 1 tournament officially kicks off on November 26th in Copenhagen. Here are the two groups. In Group A, Heroic, Gaming Gladiators, Team Falcons, BetBoon Team, and Paravision. In Group B, Extreme Gaming, Tundra Esports, Team Liquid, Team Spirit, and OG. All games in the group stages are best of one. The first place teams are seeded directly into the semifinals. Second place teams are seeded directly into the quarterfinals. Third place teams are seeded into round 2. And the fourth and fifth place teams are seeded into round 1, which they will have to play each other to move on. It is a single elimination bracket. Essentially, if you play well, you will be watching a lot of games. If you lose a lot of your games, you will be playing a lot if you want to win Blast Slam 1. Hopefully it's not too confusing to understand. Valve also released patch 7.37e. There were a lot of rebalances, potentially the biggest comes to Luna. Her level 20 talent that fires off 2 Moonglaves have been replaced with 110 Lucent Beam damage. Warlock's Imp also got nerfed. They no longer explode if they are killed by enemy heroes. The Nessa Thorn also received the patch, so check out the full patch details. That's all for this week. Check back next week for the end of the Blast Slam. Like, share, and subscribe.